第12回日本語の文法のクラス JLPT N3。 こんにちは、スー先生です。皆さんお元気ですか？今日は日本語文法の第12回のクラスです。 Today let's study all the grammar related to koto in the grammar of JLPT N3 in a series. If you study grammar that is related to the same word, you will remember it for a long time. And when you make sentences using the word, the frequency of making mistakes will decrease. Then shall we master the grammar related to koto together?Let's study koto with the idea of perfect mastering it today, okay? First of all, the grammar meaning of koto is a thing, which is similar to mono. The difference is that mono means something that is visible or concrete, and koto means something that is invisible and abstract. For example, 目に見えること means an abstract situation in general.While 目に見えるもの means something specifically in front of you. JLPT N3 grammar has 6 grammar rules related to koto. Shall we start studying one by one? Number 1, koto. As I explained earlier, if you write koto separately, it's a thing. But if you put it at the end of the sentence and finish the sentence, it's used in a different expression. Meaning is must do. Formation is verb dictionary form plus koto, verb nai form plus koto. For example, never contact your friends. Contact is 連絡. Never contact 連絡しない. Then the sentence will be 友達とは絶対に連絡しないこと. So you have to finish koto like this.And if you are on a diet, don't eat anything after 6 p.m., right? So after 6 p.m. is 夜6時以降, right? And then don't eat, 食べない. So the sentence will be, ダイエットするなら夜6時以降は何も食べないこと. Like this, you have to finish こと. Like this sentence is meaning しなさい. So 連絡しなさい, 連絡してください, right? So しなさい or してください. So it is an expression that can be used to write instructions or rules or to communicate them in words. Then let's see number 2, koto da. It doesn't just end with koto like number 1, but if you end with da, so koto da, you can express it in a different way. So meaning is should. It is used when giving suggestions or advice. The formation is verb dictionary form koto da.Verb nai form koto da. So for example, it's about walking your own life. Walking is 歩く歩む and your own life is 自分の人生. You can make a sentence like this. 自分の人生を歩むことだ. And then second example is now it's time to think about what you really want to do the most. The most is 一番 and the really want to do 一番したいこと. Sentence will be 今は自分が本当に何が一番したいことか考えて決めることだ。You have to finish ことだ like this. Like these examples, it is used in a similar sense to しなさい or した方がいい or negative way is するな or しない方がいい and often speaks by someone whose power or position is higher than the listener as an adult speaks to children. Okay?Then let's see number 3. Then how about ことがある? ことがある. The meaning is there are times when or something happens on occasions. Formation is a verb casual non-past form ことがある. So for example, sometimes short conversations can be long and memorable. Memorable is 思い出に残る. And long is 長く. So long and memorable. 長く思い出に残る. So if you make a full sentence is 時には短い会話が長く思い出に残ることがある. And second example is sometimes I suddenly remember when I was little. When I was little, 小さい時 suddenly is 急に。So if you make a full sentence, it's 急に小さい時のことを思い出すことがある。Like these examples, it's not something that happens all the time. It's an expression that happens sometimes. Then let's see number four. So what does it mean to end with ことか? For example, how good would this be if it were a joke? So joke is 冗談. So これが冗談ならどんなにいいことか? Second example, so how much I was healed by this scenery. Scenery is 景色. Be healed is 癒される. So if you make a full sentence, この景色にどんなに癒されたことか? Like this, this is ending that the speaker uses to express his feelings strongly like 非常に感じる。 Then number five, let's find out about ことに。 The expression is used as a link in the middle of a sentence. Meaning is to my, or it used as an adverb's meaning, like ly. Formation is a verb casual ことに、e adjective ことに、な adjective you have to add な and then ことに。 For example, fortunately, there were no figures outside the fence. Fence is hay, and the outside the fence is hay の外. Figures is 人影. So, if you make a full sentence, 幸せなことに hay の外にも人影はなかった。Next example is unfortunately, I didn't pass this test either. Test is testo, and then pass, 合格する, can say, 残念なことに今回のテストも合格できませんでした。 Like these examples, the next words cannot come with expressions of one's will. Words that express real, real things, or things that are already done come next. And the words that are commonly used in this expression, to my surprise,驚いたことに Sadly 悲しいことに Interestingly 面白いことに Unfortunately 悔しいことに Be in trouble 困ったことに Thankfully ありがたいことに Then practice using these expressions to make examples and it's good to understand this grammar. For example, thankfully So ありがたいことに Right? Thankfully I work healthy even in corona situation. So ありがたいことにコロナの時でも健康にお仕事をしていLike number six, it's today's last grammar rule. So, ことはない. Meaning is there is no need to. Something never happens. So, formation is a verb dictionary form, ことはない. So, really simple. Then, the first example is if you make a mistake, you won't be discouraged. Discouraged is 気を落とす. 失敗する is mistake. Make a mistake. Failed. The full sentence will be 失敗しても気を落とすことはない. Then, next example. I don't think I was so angry with my child. Angry is 怒る, right? Then, to my child, 子供に. Full sentence will be 子供にそんなに怒ることはなかったと思います. Like this example, it is used as する必要はない. Or, しない方がいい。It's an expression used to give advice or advice to a troubled person or to criticize an action. Today's class has studied the various grammar rules that are used with the simple word koto. Simple words can be different expression even if you change the expression a little. So you have to make more expressions and practice them. If you are not confident in your own expressions, please write them down in the comment section. I will look at the expression and let you know if there is anything to correct. Su sensei always supports your Japanese studies. Thank you for your like, subscribe, and comments. It would be my happiness and energy to make the next class. よろしくお願いします。それではまた。今まで Su sensei でした。